viewer, welcome to Artistry. I am your presenter, Tirus Wanyoike. Now today we have a bit of machine work to do. We have a portable machine that we call the router. The router has so many uses. It is used to put patterns on pieces of furniture. It is used to put such patterns as these ones. On this board, you would see it also has a pattern put on it. It's a decorative pattern. It adds beauty and breaks the monotony in the plain surface of the piece of wood. So this is meant to be a door jamb for a frame, for a lining, a door lining. So it will be either vertical or crossing underneath an opening. So with that decorative mold, then it becomes very attractive. After finishing, then it becomes very nice. So for us to achieve this, we have to get a router bit that suits that purpose. So we have the router here, the router machine. We have the fence. This part of this router machine is the fence, and the router machine itself is this side, this one here. This is the router machine. I have fixed the fence because we are going to use it here on this piece of wood. So this piece has no decoration. This piece has decoration. So I want to have decoration on this piece. So what I do, I will measure from the end for them to be the same. This is 150 millimeters and 150 millimeters from the end this side. And I'll measure here. I have taken that measurement and put a square mark. And on the other side, I do likewise. 150 millimeters, I put a square mark. So that is up to where that decoration is going to reach. So I'll not have a problem now guessing how much should I push this side. Did I leave it so far away? We work with measurements. So I will use an F-clamp to fasten my piece. I will use F-clamp to fasten my piece and a scrap wood piece also, a waste piece, to protect my surface from the rough edges of the metal F-clamp. F-clamp is metallic, and so to avoid its edges injuring my surface, I'll have to use some scrap wood. Scrap wood as well. Let me use two of them so that it will be completely stable as I work on it. So we shall do it together, then we shall see the results. So I fasten it using the F-clamp. I fasten it, then I have fitted my bit. My bit is now on. This bit is the one that I used to put the decoration. And then from there, the fence has been adjusted from this fence up to the center of this bit here. It's exactly the same as from this edge up to the center of this decoration. So I've done that measurement, I've adjusted it. Now I'm ready to go. So I have clamped my piece. So what remains now is only the depth. The depth I'm going to adjust so that it will not be so deep. So that is up to the surface of the wood. Then I'll press here and move it down. So now it cannot go down more than that. So what I use now to adjust the depth, the 2 millimeter depth, is the space between this screw and this stop here. So I'll unscrew and look at the gap here. I'll approximate about 2 millimeters, and there it is. So I have about 2 millimeters. Now I'll release this one. I'll lift it a little bit and then bring it up to there, and here we go. Now I have a 2 millimeter depth. Now I'm good to go. So the handle, the power switch, the depth control switch. So I'm going to use the power switch now, and the machine is quite noisy, so I have to be very careful as I handle it so that it doesn't affect my concentration, or even I don't injure myself. So I move now. Let me put on power. It's advisable to adjust it when power is off. So I put off on power, and then I put on power here now. Yes, I now have it. So it's now well decorated. So before I move my clamps further so that I can do now the remaining bit here where the clamps were. The fence could not move there. So I take good care of the power cable so that it is not cut by the blade as it rotates. Then I move on. I lift it a little bit as I start, and then off we go. Good. The line is now continuous from end to end. So I unscrew my F-clamps and turn it. Turn it and clamp it. And one clamp seems to be strong enough, so I use one and move on. Finally, we have this part done and the other part done. Now, we have seen the use of the bead where putting the decorative line or pattern is concerned. So it's important to know these things and to have an idea. Even as you go to the fundi, you must know what to expect from him. If he has the power tools, then you may consider him. May charge you a little bit expensive, but it might be worth, because you will use less time, you will get more accuracy, and also it shows a bit of seriousness where he has invested in so much to give you the service you desire. So it's important to know the use of this machine. You can open and fit any bit that you desire to fit here. So just to remind us, let us see the process of opening and fitting another bit. So we release for us to get that space. We release it, it goes back up, and then we have this point here that to get hold of the rotating shaft. So I press it, the spring loaded, I press it, turn this one a little bit, and then it clicks there. Then I will open it. Then I remove the bit. So I'll remove the collet, and then I'll have the bit and put it well. So for any other decorative purpose, the router can be used. What varies is that the bit that you fit here, it may either be a straight bit we might be used even to put this groove that you see here. Although the bit that we use there, then it should be about 3 millimeters, and 3 millimeters you have to be careful with the router because of the high speed rotation. It might break the bit if you are not careful, if you take it off a little bit. So it can also put such a groove, but this groove has been put using a table saw. Table saw is the many of us call it the circular saw, but many saws are circular. So the table saw will be a blade will come out on a table. So the table will offer you the platform, and then the blade will come out somewhere in the middle. Then you'll put the groove with a fence, and as well you can do it with the router, the router machine. So you can as well do the groove using a plane, a hand plane that we call the plow plane. The plow plane is used to put the groove. This one, if you completely don't have the power tools, or there is no power and you need to do it, then you use the plow plane to put the groove here on this side. So with that piece that way and this one this way, if you need to join them, then you can introduce a feather. Feather is a thin piece of plywood that will get into this piece and also into this other piece, and then we have our clamps. We clamp them together, glue them, and then fasten them on the sash clamps, and then we have a whiteboard. But now for these ones, they have already been laminated. We have put the various pieces of wood together, and then we have sanded, planed and sanded it. Then we have put some decoration on it. Now it looks like one piece that is ready now for use on site or for whatever other purpose. So it's important to know about these various designs. You can put a decorated design as well. This one is just a plain line. So the thickness, or rather the width of this line may vary. The decoration inside there also may vary. So it depends with exactly what you want. And as much as you get what you want, you have the way to do it. We have done it practically. And from there now you're good to go. You can always have what you want, especially for your curtain boxes also. I see a lot of decoration on the other side of the curtain boxes. You can choose to have a flat surface on the other side, and then somewhere in the middle, you have such lines as those ones. You can imagine if this this one we were structuring a curtain box, then we just put a little bit piece of a piece this side, another piece that side, and then the plain surface with that line will give you a very unique curtain box. We don't have always to copy what we have found in the market. We can always improvise and do a fresh idea on our curtain box, on something else that we also have to improvise. Now, with that in mind, we can have now the idea that we can put on many many flat surfaces. Flat surface meaning on your bench you may need a stop on the far end, so that even if a pen may roll, it will not go beyond there. So on the far side of your desk, if it is wooden, of course manufactured board will not work. If it is wooden, then the pencil may roll only up to there, and then it will be arrested, it will not fall on the side. So such ideas are incorporated when we come to breaking the monotony also for wide surfaces. So there is there are other many functions that the router may be used for, and also among them I have made an item here that is used for to hold my phone. So my phone, I was putting it like this before, and I know many of us do that. So when you are putting it this way now, the camera is might get scratched, because now if we move it up sideways, the camera on the other side and the back cover may suffer some injuries. Now once you are scrubbing it against the surface, there might be even some metallic surfaces. So to get a solution for myself, you may buy it also. The idea, I have made this hole at an angle also. I used this machine. I set it at an angle, and then I cut that hole down there. I had another phone now, it could not fit. That is why I extended. You can see this side is a bit different from this, but now we can have the both sides well rounded like this one. We use a straight bit here on the router, and then we run it here at an angle. And so you get to achieve such a surface. And then the same machine also does the mold on the sides. You have a bit to do the molding, you have a bit to do the mold all through, and also to cut, the straight bit to cut for whatever purpose you want. The width also will be determined by the bit that you fit there. So after doing my measurements, I found out that I can improvise and make a stand for my phone that will be very convenient for me to use it on the bench. Even at home, whenever I'm charging, the charging port is up here. I just plug in. If I have earphones, I also plug them here. And also the volume controls are here. There is nothing hiding back inside there. So it's a good item or such an important item. You can think about it. Go with this idea to your local fundi, and then perhaps you can sell the idea, and it could be good for you and also for him to get an idea. So the router has so many uses. We can use it to recess for such provisions. We can use it to do the molds on this. We can put a decorative mold or a trim on this. You can see the edges of this tool, they have been well rounded. The router also did it. We have a bit to round these edges. We have a bit to put this. We have a bit to put this. We have a bit to put this. There are so many things that the router can do. And we have also said we can also use the router to put the groove. So we may not exhaust the uses of this machine. And for now, we will take a break. And once we come back, we are going to look at another concept. With this in mind now, we can be able to have a start on what we are designing or what we want to do or to use. So we take a break. I will be back. Stay tuned.